I'm Katie, kitchen manager here at Purple Porch Co-op. For our annual meeting meal this year, we're offering a vegan ratatouille. Our ratatouille recipe was developed by team member Kane, who's been with our staff for about 3 years now. Our ratatouille features local seasonal vegetables like zucchini from Ridgelane Farms, and we'll be serving it over a vegan polenta, which is a seasoned ground cornmeal. We'll also have little cups of vegan Parmesan cheese, and you'll be able to find it all in our deli case while supplies last.
My name is Kane. I've worked at Purple Porch for about 3 years, and this is my riff off of a traditional ratatouille recipe.
Ratatouille is traditionally made with vegetables found in the southeastern countryside of France. The original name for ratatouille is actually ratatouille niçois, as in Nice. Ratatouille is made using exotic French vegetables like the aubergine, the eggplant, or courgette, zucchini. All you need to make delicious ratatouille is eggplant, zucchinis, onions, tomatoes, and bell peppers. Those are the traditional vegetables. However, you can add any kind of vegetables you like. When I make it at home, I like to add sweet potatoes and mushrooms. I also do whole peeled garlic cloves, roasted those up in the oven. They're very good. The world is your oyster. Don't put oysters in your ratatouille.
So basically what we're gonna do is we have olive oil in a pan already. I'm gonna turn the heat on, a good medium high heat, and then add our onions directly into the pan immediately. And let those cook up just a bit. You don't wanna saute them up entirely, you just wanna get them nice and softened up before we add in our garlic. And what we're making right now is going to be the sauce, basically the foundation of the ratatouille dish. Okay, so we've got the onion softened up a little bit. Next, we're gonna add our garlic, about 2 tablespoons worth, right into the pan. Stir that up. Turn your heat down just a teeny bit, because you don't want the garlic to burn. You do kind of want it to stick to the pan a little bit, but burnt garlic, it's gonna bring through this really bitter taste that you're gonna be able to taste throughout the whole sauce, which is not very good. We're gonna wait for the onions to get translucent. Next up, we're gonna grab our parsley. I used fresh parsley. I chopped it up, diced it up really fine. You can use dry parsley, but if you use dry parsley, you're gonna wanna use about half the amount. Into the pan. Give that a good stir. Next, I'm gonna be adding my red pepper flakes. I use a small amount for this batch. This is gonna make about 8 servings of sauce. I only use about 1 teaspoon's worth. This is fresh red pepper flakes, and the fresher the red pepper flakes, the more that spice is gonna come through after it's been sauteed and rehydrated. At this point, your onions are gonna be a little caramelized. They're translucent, your parsley, the super green pop of parsley. Everything's gonna be cooking down. Like I said, if you use fresh parsley, you can keep it it's gonna look like you have too much parsley, but it cooks down. Next, I'm gonna grab the carrots, which I'm gonna add in. These guys, I just dice up a little smaller. If you leave the carrots too thick, then you run the chance of them not sauteing up properly, and you'll have soft outsides and hard insides. By the point you add the carrots, your onions and garlic should begin to stick to the pan, which is fine. Just continue moving it around with the carrots. Let the carrots cook up just a little bit to release leftover moisture that they've got inside. And then you can leave it for just a moment to finish off entirely before killing the heat. When you kill the heat, your vegetables should be basically sticking to the pan. You almost have to scrape up the garlic. At this point, we're going to do something called deglazing. I'm gonna add my red wine vinegar. And I'm gonna do just a splash of the red wine vinegar. That's all you need. That little bit there is gonna help release all that browned up vegetable goodness. and it's gonna add a sort of the like vinegar, sweet, sour kind of flavor to your sauce all the way through. You can even hear it, like audibly, it's not as sizzly, it's not as sticking to the pan anymore. Next up, we're gonna add our tomatoes. And I've got about 6 cups of organic tomato here, diced tomato. And it's just gonna go right into the pan, juice and all. And the leftover tomato juice actually from the canned tomatoes is also going to help release whatever leftover veggies are in there. Give it a good stir. Make sure you get everything released from the pan. So next we're gonna add our tomato puree. You're gonna add the entire 28-ounce can of tomatoes. Make sure you get out everything that you can. We're gonna stir up the tomato puree. And then add our salt and pepper. So for this whole thing, again, this is about 8 servings. I do 1 single tablespoon of salt, and that's really all you need. And that salt's gonna help cut through all of the sweetness from the onions and the tomatoes and the carrots. And it's also gonna help bring out the muted flavors now of like the olive oil and the vinegar. And finally, our black pepper. I am a big proponent that you should always salt and pepper literally every dish you make. And so for this, I will use about 1/2 teaspoon. Mix it up. So next up, I'm gonna blend it with the immersion blender. Doing this step is really important in my opinion. It brings together all of the flavors of the sauce. You have the oil, the vinegar, the salt, the pepper, all of the sweetness from all the fresh vegetables, the onion, the tomato, the parsley, everything in it just comes together in this delicious just vegetable sauce that's super versatile. You can add cheese, you can add meat, you can keep it as is. It's actually vegan the way it is currently. So it's entirely up to you how you'd like to do it. So this ratatouille recipe is really good to eat just by itself with the veggies and the sauce. However, if you want to go the extra mile, you can eat it with pasta or polenta. Polenta is really easy to make. All you need are 3 ingredients. You have your cornmeal, your water or vegetable broth, and your butter. So basically all you're going to do is you're going to add your cornmeal and your liquid into a pot. Get that nice and hot and add your butter. Stir it until it becomes nice and thick, and then you can kill the heat. You're all done. All you do is you add salt and pepper, and you have a delicious polenta to eat with your ratatouille. You can also add cheese to that and have a very good cheesy polenta to eat with your ratatouille.
Hi, my name is Christy. I'm the general manager here at Purple Porch Food Co-op. As you heard Kane allude to earlier, this delicious sauce recipe that you just saw is getting tossed with eggplants and roasted zucchini and onions and bell peppers and served over top of polenta. And that's going to be available in our deli case grab and go section. We have lots of delicious items in there. So as I say every day, thank you so much for supporting the porch, because when you do, you help to support all of the local farmers and entrepreneurs in our community that we purchase our items from and source from every day. So thank you. We appreciate it.